here at the Bio CEO and Investor Conference at the Marriott Marquis. With me, I have William McVicar. William, how are you?
I'm well, thank you.
So tell me about your company and kind of what kind of news you have right now.
Well, we have a very exciting news year coming up in 2018 with clinical trials reading out in the first quarter as well as in the third quarter in serious neurological diseases, ALS, multiple sclerosis, and Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease.
What is kind of your goals that you're looking forward to for the year?
Well, we have a great solid set of trials ongoing, so we really just want to execute, deliver a high quality data, and then be able to demonstrate that our neurostimulation technology can prevent cramping, which is a serious and debilitating symptom for these patients. And in fact, this year we were just granted fast track designation from FDA for the treatment of cramps in ALS.
Give me the kind of backstory behind all of this and how the technology was discovered.
It's a fascinating backstory. It was actually discovered by a Nobel Prize laureate neuroscientist at Harvard and his buddy who liked to kayak. And they had developed cramping in their arms when they were kayaking. And they went back to the lab and figured out exactly how to solve that cramping problem. And it turns out that it dovetailed very nicely with his basic research into ion channel biology, which is why he won the Nobel Prize.
And is there kind of any other competitors in this space?
There is absolutely nothing indicated for cramping in the United States. And it's a terrible problem. And for ALS patients alone, 90% of them have cramping. And if you ask them where their pain comes from, most of the pain that they suffer comes from this cramping problem. And I think this is really underlies why the FDA said to us, this is really a serious and unmet medical need and granted us a fast track designation.
How many people does this affect in the world?
In ALS, there's about 20,000 patients in the U.S., but in Charcot-Marie-Tooth disease, it is actually the largest inherited neuropathy. There's more like 150,000 patients in the U.S. Now, not all of them cramp, but there is a good proportion of them that have serious daily cramps that interfere with their functioning and daily activities.
So what you're doing is really going to help so many people.
Oh, we believe it can be very impactful for not only patients with ALS, but also Charcot-Marie-Tooth and potentially MS patients that suffer from spasticity, another huge problem.
Can you give me some insight onto your team?
Yeah, we have an excellent team, along with our scientific advisory board with Nobel Prize laureates, and we have the chief medical officer from Biogen. Al Sandrock is on our scientific advisory board. Our clinical team has Tom Wessel, who I've worked with for many years in a previous company. And the company was founded by Christoph Westphal, who is very well known in the biotechnology area. He's started more than seven companies and created many, many billions of dollars in value for investors.
What are you hoping to achieve by being here today?
Basically, we just want to get our story out and to let people know that this is going to be a very exciting year for Flex Pharma. It's a really interesting time to look at the technology, to look at where we might be, and just a year from now, it could be a very, very dramatic and important year for the company.
Well, William, it all sounds very exciting. Thank you so much for joining us here today.
You're most welcome. My pleasure, Christine.